Hi students, now in this video we take the second chapter of class 9 physics, that is force and laws of motion. Here this chapter divided two parts. One part is about the study of force, definition of force, effect of force and the common forces. And then in second part is, that is laws of motion, that is Newton first law, Newton second law, Newton third law. Okay, but in this video I cover only the force, concept of force here, right? So let us see about the force, and let us try to define the what is the meaning of force here, right? Force here. For understanding the definition of force, let us try to take some examples here, right? For example, I take a block here or a body here, right? I take a body of something, mass is there, 1 kg, 2 kg, something mass m is there, okay? Something mass m is there. So we know that in the 8th standard, we study about the force. Push is at one type of force. Pull is a one type of force, right? I can here push the object, okay? I can push the object, and this pushing nothing but what? It is nothing but what? It is a kind of force, right? It is a kind of force, right? And when I apply a pushing force on the block, what happened? The block start to accelerate with the acceleration, that is A. Okay, the body start to accelerate. What is acceleration? Rate of change of velocity. When the force is zero, the acceleration is equal to zero. Right? How it is? See, here we know that A is equal to V minus U by T. Okay? When the object is at rest, what happened? Initial velocity is zero, and object is rest means final velocity is zero by something, that is zero. So acceleration is zero, right? If the object is rest, means that there is no external force applied on the object, right? If there is no external force, that is what the external force F is equal to zero on the object, what happened? The object is not move, the object is in the state of rest. Okay, and the state of rest, what happened? The acceleration is zero. Why? Because there is no initial velocity. If there is no initial velocity, if the object is not move, it not attain the final velocity. So initial velocity zero, final velocity zero, time also not taken here. So what happened? We get a zero here. So acceleration is zero. But when we apply a force, what happened? When you apply a force, the force is not equal to zero, then acceleration is not equal to zero. Then there is something acceleration is there, right? For example, at the starting, the object is in initial velocity of the object is zero. When the push, we apply a force, when you push the object, what happened? The object start to accelerate and it attain the velocity v. So this, then what happened? There is an acceleration, that is, see here, A is equal to v minus u divided by t. If the force is applied, then there is a v velocity and initial zero that time. So what happened? Acceleration is equal to v by t. There is a something acceleration is there, not zero, but something acceleration is there. So that is, we say that whenever a force is applied on an object, the object start to accelerate. Means that when the force is not equal to zero, then acceleration is not also not equal to zero. Then the what happened? The force is in the something direction. So we observe that the force in the direction is there. Okay, whenever we push the object in the some direction, so we say that force have direction, right? Force have direction, because when we apply force, what happened? We give some direction to the, okay, I apply a block for in north direction, south direction, any directions, up or down. So we observe that when you apply a force, the object to show a direction. So that is called as force have direction. And also I push an object with greater force or maybe smaller force, my choice is there. So we observe that if I push an object with a greater force, it have more acceleration. If I have apply less push or less force, what happened? It is a low acceleration. So finally, we observe that there is a magnitude of acceleration, force is there. Okay, maybe force large, maybe force small here. So we say that force have magnitude. Magnitude. So we know that a quantity, a physical quantity which have both magnitude and direction is called as vector quantity. So we observe that the physical quantity force, we observe that the physical quantity, that is force, has both both magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction. So it is called as, vector quantity. Force, it is, so is, then sorry, then force is vector quantity, right? So see here how we define the vector quantity here, both magnitude and direction. So we observe that we apply a force in the something direction. So force has a direction, and we apply a force on the object, may be large or may be small, that is magnitude. So that is called a force having both magnitude and direction. So force is a vector quantity. So that must be you remember in the examination, may be asked. Force is a option, A scalar quantity, vector quantity, none of these something. So we observe, we can tick on the vector quantity. So how the force is a vector quantity? Because we apply force in the different direction, and we apply force may be large or may be small. So different direction is a direction, and the force may be small or large, it is a magnitude. Okay, so we get one point here. Whenever a apply force on the object, what happened? The object start to accelerate in the something direction. So that is called a vector quantity, we can say, right? So we observe that the object is at first rest. Whenever we apply the force, then what happened? The object start to move. Now we can easily define force, that force is a cause. Force is the cause that produced acceleration in the body on which forces act, on which forces act, right? So that is very important definition of force. So force is what? Force is nothing but is a cause, is a result, it is nothing but what? Simple, it is result. Okay, force may be in the form of pull, or maybe in the form of push, or maybe in the form of hit, right? If I pull a block, what happens? The block is move. I push a door, what happened? The door is open. We in the mall, we observe the doors pushing, pulling door, pulling, pushing door. When I enter the bank, we observe that is right, pull or push. We pull the door, what happened? The force is applied by the palm. And what happened? The door is open. If I pull the door, then now sometime it is pulling, the door is there. And then what happened? I apply force towards me. Pushing is the force away from you. And pulling the force, nothing but the force towards you. Totally this force is there. And that force, what the make? The force make the body to be move. Maybe forward direction or maybe backward direction. But totally the body is at zero acceleration. But when apply the force, maybe the pulling, maybe pushing, or in the cricket, maybe hitting. Okay, when maybe hitting 4 or 6, what happened? You apply force. Okay, the bat exert a force on the ball. That can ball can be move one place to another place. So there is exert a force. So that is what? The force is a cause that produce acceleration in the body, that make body to move. Okay, that make body to move, on which the forces act. Which body move? On which the forces act. If I apply force on that body, okay, I apply force on that body can move. That body can accelerate from one place to another place. That is what the cause of force. And also we can define force like that. What is the force? So we say that force is a cause, is a reason behind the motion of an object. The earth is revolve around the sun, the planets are revolving. It is because of the, there is something force between the sun and the earth is there. Something of force between moon and earth is there. That we learn in the next classes. Okay, next class. But we observe that the force nothing but a cause of motion. We also say that force is a cause of motion. We also say that force is a cause of motion. Cause of motion. So motion nothing but the motion, but the changing the place. Changing the place. If the place change means the velocity changing. The velocity changing means there is a produce an acceleration. So that is a finally right sentence, that the force is a cause that produce an acceleration in the body on which the force is applied here. Okay, students. So this is about the force definition. Right? It is about the force definition. And see here, force may be two, so many times. That is, see here, if I apply, okay, force, maybe the force is pushing. Pushing is a force. okay, pushing is a force, then what happened? The direction of acceleration is this direction and the motion also this direction. Okay, the direction of force and the direction of motion are both are same, right? And also sometime if an object is in the moving state, okay, in the object is moving, moving object, and then moving object having some acceleration, okay, some acceleration, and there is a some velocity also, okay, some acceleration is there, and to stop the moving object, see here, to start the moving object, okay, to start the rest, so to move the rest object, okay, to move the rest object, we need force, need force, right? That is very important. Means to change the speed of an object, we required a, what happened? We required a force, right? From zero to something value. If an object is moving, what happened? We apply the force in this direction, right? The motion in this direction and the force in opposite direction. This is motion direction and this is a forward direction. Both are opposite. When the force and motion are opposite, what happened here? The object is stopped here. So what? Apply force to stopping the object. Apply the force to stop the object. Right? Totally observe that if you want to move the object, we require the force. We want to stop the object, we require the force. What happened? There is a change in the speed. Okay? So increase the speed, to decrease the speed, to increase the velocity, to decrease the velocity, okay, to make the rest to motion, motion to rest, in the all the case, we require a force here, okay, maybe pushing, maybe putting or pushing or pulling or maybe hitting, any kind of force we can take here, right? So we observe that, first point is observe that the force on the set, the forces or the set of forces on the object can change the speed of the object, okay, from zero to something value or from something value to make it zero. So we can change the speed of the object by applying the force here. Also see, if I hit a ball, okay, if I hit a ball, then what happened? The ball is moving in this direction, okay, the ball moving in this direction. When apply force in this direction, what happened? The ball move in this direction. If I apply force in this direction, what happened? The ball move in like this direction. So what happened? The direction of the ball, it changes here. How the direction of ball, that because ball is non-living things, how it changes direction? Because of the force. When the force in this direction, the force direction and motion is same. When the force in this direction, the object in the direction of force, motion direction of force, and then ball here means we apply force here, then force and the motion in the direction of each other same. Right? So we observe that the direction of object can also be changed by applying the force here. Correct, students? One is rest to motion, speed of the velocity changes. Motion to rest, the speed of the velocity changes. Okay, speed of the body changes. So to increase or decrease the speed, to change the speed of the object, we require the force. And we want to change the direction of the object, we require here force. That is very important. And one thing is there, if you take a balloon here, okay, take a balloon, okay, and apply the force with your palm, apply the force, pushing force, okay, push, what happened? We observe that the size of the balloon like that, it is pressed, the size of the balloon get small, it is pressed, so it is volume is changed, its size is changed, so we say that, okay, we say that when the force is applied on the object size is changes. For example, if I apply force on the any hard stone, what happened? The stone break into pieces. So we observe that the stone got to get changes shape. So we observe that when you apply force on the object, because of the force, the object changes its shape. So these are three causes of motion. One cause is change in the speed. Second cause is change in the direction, and the third cause is that is change in the shape. So that is called as three cause of forces here. Okay, so we can write here after definition of force, we can write next point, that is cause of three cause of force. Okay, so please write down here. Right here, we see that a force or a or a set of forces acting on a body can do three things. So the first one is a force or set of forces can change the speed of a body, right? First one, we always said speed of body. If the object is at rest, the speed is zero. When apply the force, they move with acceleration, something speed. If the moving object gets stopped, it is velocity kind of decreasing, speed decreasing. So increase or decrease the speed with help of force. And next one, second is a force or a set of forces can change the direction. Can change the direction of motion, right? Change the direction of motion of a body. For example, cricket ball or in the football, you observe that the football is kicked by the different player and can observe that different direction is decided by the ball. Okay, football sometime in this direction, in the forward direction, in the backward direction, in the cross direction, number of directions, up or down. So by hitting the with a foot, what happens? The direction of the football is changes because of when they apply force by their legs. So that is direction changes here, right? And then third one and last one, that is a set of forces can change. Here set of force required, okay? One set is not set of force, one set, two set of force are required. So set of forces can change the shape of a body. Like for example, balloon is there, spring is there, okay? If I elongate the spring, I can pull the spring. What happened? The spring shape is changed. I release the spring. What happened? The spring in normal size. If I push the spring, what happened? The spring gets small, okay, compressed. So that is we change the spring length, okay? That is what's nothing but shape, okay? So this is what like that, okay? It is spring is there. It is the normal size. If I pull the spring and what happened? The size is increased like that. The size is increases, length is double. If I apply a push the terminus, what happened? The spring is get small, okay? Size is decrease. See, normal size, when I pull it one, the size is increases, shape is change. And when I apply push the spring and what happened? The spring gets small, the shape is changed here. So we say that when a set of forces are applied on the body, what happened? The body changes shape. So that is students about the forces here. So one is what about the force is a cause that produces acceleration in the body, right? If the body is your rest and the body can be moved with help of the force, when the force is applied, there is an acceleration in the body, right? And then there are three set of, okay, when there are three things when the force is applied on the body, what happened? One may be happen the change in the velocity, speed or velocity, change in the speed, and the change in the speed and change the direction, right? And then change in the shape. So three things happen when the force is applied on the body, students, okay? So these students about the force here. All right, now let us take some important, the two types of force we study here, right? In this class or in the last standard, we study introduce a two types of force, right? Two types of forces here. Let's see one by one. So two types of forces we study here. Two types of forces. Okay, one is called as balanced force, and the second one is called as unbalanced force. So what is the difference between balanced force and unbalanced force? We now learn here, right? So see simple definition here. In the balanced force, right? For example, I take a block here. So see, if I apply force in the V direction, it is taken in the apply force in this is west east direction. Okay, we observe that the motion is also in the east direction. Okay, observe motion in east direction. If I take another block, right, another block, and apply a force in the west direction, what happened? Then the motion is also in the west direction. Okay, motion is also in the west direction. So we observe that when a force is applied, the direction of motion is the direction of force is there, right? Now, if I see, I take a same block and I take my two hand and my this hand is apply force towards this, okay? And my second hand, okay, this left hand apply the force on this. And condition that I take this force is F1 by the left hand and this force is taken as F2 by the right hand. And if these forces are equal, see here, very interesting point is there. For example, I take this is a block. I apply force on this end and then apply force on this end, right? If this is my right hand, if I apply the force from right hand, then what happens? The object is move in the right direction. If I apply force to this left hand, what happens? The object is move, right? If I apply the force at both sides, right? And the condition is the force applied by the right hand and the force applied by the left hand on the end of the object is equal. F1 equal to F2. What happens here? The object is applying force here. I pushing, you observe muscles here. Observe the muscles, I pushing in this one. But what happened here? The object is does not move, right? The object is does not move. Whenever a force is, we have learned that when the force is applied, the object is start to accelerate. But you observe that when the forces are up, set of forces are applied, the object is not to move. So why the object is not to move? Because the force I applied on the end of the object, both are same. When the force applied on the object are balanced, then there is no acceleration in the object, then object is not move, and that is called as balanced force, right? The set of forces acting on the body produce no acceleration. We observe that it is one set of force. When those two set of force is acting on the body, then there is no acceleration in the body, then the body is not to move, the body is still at the rest. So that is called as balanced forces, right? That is called as balanced force. Can I please draw this one, pause the video and draw this one. When the force is this direction, the object move in this direction, the force in this direction, the object move in this direction. But when the force, both forces are equal to each other, the force from the left side and the force from the right side, both are equal to each other, the F1, F2, that is called as a balanced forces is there. Okay, balanced force. And these balanced forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Okay, so I can define here the balanced force. Let us see here the balanced force here. So the balanced force, so I can help of diagram, see from help of diagram, that is taken as F, okay, of mass M. A force F is applied from this direction and the force F is applied from this direction. So I write here force F1 is equal to F2. Force F1 is equal to F2. Right? Force F1 is equal to F2. I write also sentence here. Force F1 and F2 are equal in magnitude. Okay, equal in magnitude. But opposite in direction. Correct, students? Opposite in direction. See here, this F1 force is act towards west and the F2 force act towards east. They are opposite, but they are equal. Because of that, I write here. They are equal. See here, forces are equal. F1 equal to F2, but they are opposite in direction. And so now I define the balance force here. See here, the balance force here, if a set of forces acting on a body produces no acceleration in it. The forces are said to be balanced. This is called balanced force. So we observe that whenever there is a balanced force on the object acceleration is zero. You must be remember. Okay? Whenever there is a balanced force on the object, force from the either side, okay? The forces applied on the object, if they are balanced, if all the forces applied on the object is balanced, so what happened? Then it is called, so acceleration is zero, the object is not to move, so that is called, the body produces no acceleration, that is, the body is not to move, not change its position, that is called balanced forces, students, right? Now let us come to the unbalanced forces, that is opposite. See here, if I take a block here of mass m, right? I apply force F1 in this direction, I apply force in F2 in this direction. Now I can take here, F1 force is greater than F2 force. Means what here? Here we say that F1 and F2 are unequal in magnitude. Okay, the magnitude is not equal. See, F1 force is greater, F2 force is smaller, right? So see here, if F1 is greater and F2 is smaller, so in which direction the object is move? Right, the direction of greater force, the direction of the motion, right? The direction of greater force like that. So what happened? The object move in this direction. Okay, the object is move in the direction of the greater force. So I write here, object is move in the direction of large force. If F1 is greater and F2 is smaller, means the motion in the direction of F1. If the F2 greater, means the motion direction of F2. But here example I take, F1 is greater. So what happened? The direction of motion in the F1 direction. So that, see here, in the unbalanced forces, the two forces are not equal. Okay, in the unbalanced forces, the set of forces are not equal. So that is called as unbalanced force. So in the unbalanced force, when there is an unbalanced force, okay, unbalanced force on the object, what happened? The object start to move, right? For example, if I can take this marker, okay, I apply the force with my fingertips on the pen, so we observe that there's no motion, so we say that, sir, the pen is not moving, so your forces are now balanced, right? Now let us see, if I apply the force like that, what happened here? Okay, see, I apply force, so where the object is moving? Object is moving in the direction of this finger, right? This finger. So we say that this finger force is greater than this finger. That is why now acceleration is observed. See here, this force is smaller, this force is larger. So see that the object moves in the direction of this force. Okay, this force. So we see that in the direction unbalanced force. So the force is not balanced. Now this greater. So one force is greater, one force is smaller, there is unbalanced force. In the unbalanced force, you observe that the pen is moving, the pen is accelerating. But when a balanced force, the pen is at the rest. So that is, we observe that. So simple one, if a set of forces acting on the body produce acceleration, then that force is called as unbalanced force, students. Okay, so please write down the definition of unbalanced force here. If a set of forces acting on a body
on a body produced a non-zero acceleration, okay? Means something accelerates, then non-zero means not equal to zero, okay? That is the sentence. Non-zero acceleration, the force are said to be unbalanced, okay? Unbalanced, and the one we got two differences. One difference is the definition. In the balanced force, there is no acceleration of the particle. In the unbalanced force, there is the acceleration of the particle. And in the balanced force, the forces are equal magnitude, but in the unbalanced force, the forces are in unequal magnitude, but opposite in direction. And the object, the direction of motion is the direction of forces, okay? The object is move in the direction of the larger force, right? If the larger force in this direction, the object move in this direction. If the larger force in this direction, the object moves in this direction, okay, students? So these are some very important point about the two types of motion. One is a balanced force and one is a unbalanced force here, right? So we have to be remember this point, right? So these are in the balance force, F1 equal to F2. In the unbalanced force, there is a no equal. Also, we write that F1 force is not equal to F2 force. Light also we have mentioned here. Okay, both are same. If you write F1 is greater than F2, or we can say that F1 is not equal to F2. Maybe F2 is greater. Okay, maybe F1 is smaller, or maybe F1 is small greater and F2 is smaller. So that case you can also mention like that F1 is not equal to F2 in the case of unbalanced force. That is why the object is move. The object gets acceleration. Okay, accelerated. But in the case of balanced force, the F1 force and the F2 force is equal to each other, but in opposite in direction. Okay, students. So this is about the types of forces here. Right, balanced force and the unbalanced force. The balanced force does not cause the motion, but the unbalanced force is a cause the motion. The unbalanced force cause the motion here, right? So I can write here unbalanced force. Okay, sorry, here unbalanced force, right? So unbalanced force. So I can remove this one, student. Please pause the video and write down all these points. Now, students, come to the some last concept, that is here some common forces here. We study about the some common forces, not detail, but some only main meaning. Okay, only meaning. Detail you can study in the class 11. Okay, in class 11 you can detail study about the that common forces. But here only the meaning is there. Okay, introduction is there. So some common forces. Some common forces. Some common forces here. So, see, the one by one forces I can take here. The first one force is, that is called contact force. Contact force. Number one is contact force. So, what is contact force, students, here? So, simple one. When a body A is in contact with body B. What does it mean? See, for example, I can take a table here. It is a table. On the table, I can put a bag. Okay, I put a bottle there. So what happened here? I can take this bottle is a object A and this table is a object B, right? Body A, it is a body A and it is a body B, right? When I kept a bottle on the object, what happened? You see that the bottle is not move, okay? But the contact is there. See, contact is there. Okay, contact is there. The contact of body A with contact of body B is the contact. Okay, see, bottle is contact with the table is there. So that is the right here. When the body A is in contact with body B, right? What happened? In that case happened, body A exert a force on body B, and
body B exert a force on body A. Right? See here. This table exert a force in upward direction of force F, that is called F1 force, and that at the same time the bottle also applied a force on the table, that is F2 force. Right? The force exerted by the object body on the body 2, and F1 force is the force applied by the body B on the body A. Right? Body A. And these are called as, okay? These forces are called as, these forces are called as contact force. Contact force. These are called as contact force. So I hold a book on the palm, that is called contact force. See here, contact is there. This is a body one, book is a body two. I kept like that, means what? Contact is there. Okay. The book apply the force on my palm, and my palm is apply the force in book. Okay. Right, that, okay, in the opposite direction. Okay. The bottle apply the force in downward direction to the table, and the table apply the force on the bottle in the upward direction. Okay. So that is what contact force is there. So simple, if I stand on the road, okay, wind touch to the body, what happened? That is contact force. Okay. Wind force is a contact force. Okay. And a book is kept on your palm is the contact force, or any load is kept on your head, it is a contact force. Okay. That is called a contact force. What happened to the contact force? In the contact force, observe that two bodies are applying force to each other. Okay, two bodies. For example, again take an example. I take a table here. On the table, I can put a block is there. This block have applied the force F1 on the table, and same time the block also apply the force F2 on the table. So because of the contact surface is there, that this force because of this contact, right? So that is called as a contact force, students. Right. So now come to the second type of, we applied on this one, what is contact force, right? Repeated, see, in the contact force, we take a two body, and both the bodies, are condition is what? I take a two body, and that both body are contact with each other, that is important, okay? When a body A is in contact with the body B, first condition, then what happened? Then body A exert, okay, push the one body to downward direction, and one body to the upward direction. Look, see here, the A exert a force on the body B, and at same time the body B exert a force on the body A. That is called as a contact force, students. Okay, please remember this definition, right? So please write down this one. Now come to the second one. Normal force. Okay, normal force. That is also same as a contact force. Okay, one is a normal force. Second one is a normal force. Normal force. Normal force. So let us see definition first about the normal force here. If the contact force between, if the contact force between two bodies are perpendicular to the surface, to the surface, surface is in contact, the forces are called normal force. Okay, students, see here, if the contact force between two bodies, I can take two bodies, for example, I can take table here, it is a table, and a table I kept a block, right? This block apply the force, because if mass apply the force F1 this direction, okay, here, see this, like that, and then what happened? And the table also apply the force upward direction. Okay, that is contact force upward direction. So here, this is F2 force. So you observe that these forces are, there are different, like the forces also there, but these forces are perpendicular to each other, 90 degree to each other. When the forces are, force applied by the body A on the body B, and the body B force applied on the body A, both are perpendicular to each other, both are 90 degree to each other. So what happened? Such force are called as a normal force. So simple one, if I kept this, okay, for example, like that. it is body one, that pen is body two. If I there are kept like that, what happens here? The force applied by the pen on the palm and the force applied by palm on the pen, both are straight line, that is per 90 degree, perpendicular. So that is called as a normal force. Whenever a force is applied on the object is at a 90 degree, so what happens? That is called normal force. If I take a palm and apply the force on the palm perpendicular to each other, so what that force is called? Normal force. So that is student right here. If the here condition also the both surface are contact with each other, condition is a contact force. So normal force is one type of contact force. We also say that normal is force is a type of contact force. It is a type of a contact force. But what is difference here? Here difference is the contact force here must be perpendicular to the surface. Perpendicular surface of contact. Okay, perpendicular surface of contact. So that is called as a normal force. So see here, if the force of contact, okay, that is force of contact between the two bodies, perpendicular surface of contact here. Okay, body A apply force, body B apply force, and these force are called as contact force, right? When the contact force is applied by the body, okay, is perpendicular to each other, perpendicular to the surface of contact, okay, then contact force is perpendicular to the which force is F1, what is type of force? F1 and F2 is a contact force, and if the these contact forces are 90 degree to each other, okay, to the surface of the contact, right, the contact forces are perpendicular to the surface of contact, is called a surface of contact, surface of contact, okay, surface of contact, then what happened? These forces are called as an contact normal force, students. Okay, so this is what the second one, normal called some common force in second force, right? So please write down this one. Now come to the third one. Now come to the third one, force, that is about a frictional force. Third one is a frictional force, or simple we call it friction. Okay, frictional force, or simple we call it as a friction. So what is this? So we observe, take a block here. Okay, this is the surface. It is one type of contact surface. It is also one type of a contact force. Okay, here also contact is there. Okay, it is a floor. For example, I take it is a floor. Okay, it is a floor. Okay, I take it as a floor, and here block is there. Okay, when I apply the force in this direction, we observe that there is a rubbing force is there. Here we found a sound, rubbing force is there. And that force in the this direction. If the force is this direction, this force in this direction. Right? That is what, whenever a body is contact with the surface, we observe that there is a fork, there is a rubbing force between the block and the surface of contact. So that force is called as a frictional force, students. Okay, so please write down here, two bodies placed in contact can also exert a force. And now these forces are look parallel here. If the block push in this direction F, then what happened? The frictional force in this direction. Okay, frictional force in, we observe that these are parallel to each other. Right? If the forces are perpendicular to the surface, are called as a normal force. If the forces are parallel to the contact surface, is called as a what? Frictional force. Simple, students, right? So two point. One is if the forces are perpendicular to the surface, what happened? Normal force. If the forces are parallel to the surface, what called as a frictional force, right? So see here, two bodies placed in contact, condition is contact here. Contact can also exert a force parallel to the surface in contact. Okay, surface in contact, such a force is called force of friction, or frictional force, or simple friction, force of friction, force of
friction or frictional force or simply it is a friction. Okay students, so this is very important point to be remembered. So please write down this, what is frictional force? Two bodies placed in a contact can also exert a force, but that force are in parallel. If that force are perpendicular, they are called normal force. If that force are parallel, then they are called as an frictional force or simple friction or a force of friction. Right students, so that is very important right here. Friction force, force of friction or frictional force. Okay, frictional force or simply friction. Simply friction. So that point you have to be remember. So please write down this one. Okay students, now take the fourth one, that is fourth one, common force. Fourth one, force, that is a force exerted by a spring. Exerted by spring. Right? So see here, if I take a spring here, we know that it is spring. Okay, it is a spring, and this is called as the end of a spring. End. Okay, it is called as the end or terminal of a spring. And now the spring in a normal length. Okay, it's a natural length. Okay, natural length. Okay, when, what is natural length? When there is a pull or push force on the spring. In that case, the spring is natural length, right? The spring is in natural length. Now, force exerted by the spring, they ask me. For example, if I take a spring, that is normal length is there. Now I can, first case it is normal length. Okay, in the first case, there is no force on the object. Okay, there is no pulling force. Maybe there is no pushing force, right? No force. That is why the spring at it normal, natural length. Okay, natural or real length. Natural length. Now, in the second case, what I can done, I can see here, I can attach two blocks at the end of a spring. Okay, here one block is there and here one block is there. That is block A is there and block B is there. Right, I attach to the end of the water spring. Now I can pull the block in the outer. Okay, I can pull the block like that. I can pull the blocks. Block one in this direction and pull the block in this direction. So what happens, students? We observe that the spring ends. Okay, we observe that, see, whenever I apply a force on this direction, the spring get elongated. What happened? The spring get elongated. What happened here? The spring is elongated. Okay, thus elongated means the length of the spring is increases. Right? When I pull the end of an spring is there. When I release the end, what happened? Then the blocker come towards each other. So what happened? The force, the blocker attract to each other. So we see that whenever I apply the force on the end of a terminal in the outward direction, so what happened? The block is pulled to each other like in this direction. In this direction. Right? In the this direction. So I can release the end. What happened? The ring come to the blocker, come to the each other, close to each other. So that is what the second point. So what happened here? Spring exert a force on the block. So that is why the blocker come towards each other. Okay, so next one, third one, if I take a spring here and I press the block, what happened here? I press the end, I press this one, I can what to push this one, here I push in this direction. Okay, what happened? Then the spring get compressed. Okay, spring get compressed. So what happened in this direction when I press this spring and I suddenly release this spring, what happened? The block move like that. So what happened? The block move like that. Okay, the block move away from each other. Okay, means what? Why block move like that? Because the force exerted by the spring in this direction, blocker come to each other. okay, when I release this force, blocks are come near to each other because of the force exerted by the spring on the blocks. And in this direction, when the block, I release the force of pushing force, what happened? The blocker go away from each other. Why? Because of the force exerted by spring on the block. Okay, so that is called as the force exerted by the spring here, students. Okay, when there is no pulling force and there is no pushing force, the spring at natural length, that is called natural length. When you pull the end of a springs, the spring get elongated, the spring length is increases. When we apply pushing force on the end of a spring, the spring get compressed. Okay, so because of compression and elongation of this elongation and compression of a spring can exert a force on the end of a spring, students, that you have to be remember. So right here, see the elongation and compression of a spring exert a force on its ends. That is why the block are coming to each other or away from the each other. So that is, student, very important point to be remember, right? So this is called as a spring force exerted by the spring. So please write down this one. Now, students, come to the last two part. Is there fifth one and sixth one? So now come to the fifth force, common force, that is called as force acted, that is fifth force, right? That is force exerted by a string. So what is string? Simple, take a string, okay, any string, and now string tag a one block is there of something mass, a block, and fix this to the something here, okay, fix to the string, we fix to the ground, okay, it is pivoted something. So what happened? We observe that this is a string, okay, this is the string. Now this is the block. When we hang the something is there, okay, take a string and tag it with a stone and hang like that, okay, hang like that. So we observe that what happened, this block is exert a force on the string, okay, this block exert a force on the string, that is F force, and that string hold the block in the upward direction, that is means the string also hold the block in and apply the force in the upward direction, and the block also touch to the string in the downward direction, okay. So force by the upward is taken as capital T, and the force exerted by the block on the string is taken as mg, okay, mass and gravity, okay, and the see here block exert a force on string is F is equal to mg, okay, F is equal to mg, and same time string, okay, pulling the block, right, there is a exert a force on the block, in which spring exert a force on the block, that is called as a T, in the upward direction, okay, in the upward direction. So in that case, observe that the whole system is at rest. So we say that force, that is upward force and downward force, both are equal to each other, that is called as T is equal to mg, okay, and T is equal to mg, students, right, T is equal to mg, right, net point is there, T is equal to mg, and this is T is called as a tension on the string, okay, tension on the string. So we can write like that, the meaning of a tension is there, the magnitude of force of the force exerted by a string on the object tied to tied to it is called tension. It is called tension, and this tension is equal to the force mg. That is why the whole system is at rest. So that is tension is calculated as a mg. How much tension is in the string? Nothing but it is a mass into gravity. That is a mass is m and gravity is how much? 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, that is we know the value. Okay, sometime we take it is 10, right? That so in the higher classes we can study how to calculate the tension, but 9 class we only discuss about the what is here. Tension is there. So tension thing, but the force exerted on the block, that is called as a tension, and that tension force is equal to the force of the block. That is why the whole system is at rest. Okay, if the tension is equal to mg, what happen? Whole system is at rest, means the acceleration of the block is zero. The acceleration of the block is zero. Why? Because of the force get cancelled to each other, okay, both force get cancelled to each other. The force of mg is cancelled by the t and the force of t is cancelled by the mg. So both are equal to each other. So what acceleration is zero? The block is at rest. So that is what the whole system is at rest. So the acceleration of the block is what? The acceleration of block is get zero. So that is student about the force exerted by the string here. So last now taken sixth one, weight. Okay, weight. So that is called a weight here. So sixth one, last four, that is a weight. That is called a weight. That is a weight here. So let us see. The earth, meaning the earth attracts all bodies towards its center. Okay, about this you can study in the later class gravitation chapter, about that whole concept, but here only we increase the point here. About weight we complete discuss in the gravitation chapter. So only here see, the earth attract all the body towards its center. The force exerted by the earth on a body is called the weight. And that force is called a weight here, right? So that force is called as a weight. So see here, earth is there. Whenever I drop something in the earth, what happened? It attracted by the earth. Anything we drop in the air, that it attracted by the earth. Okay, that is what the object, the earth attract every object towards its center, and that is called as an weight. Okay, that is called as a force. So that is a force. We also say that the force exerted by the earth on the objects is called as an weight, and that is represented by this formula. Weight is equal to, okay, that is m is the mass of the body and g is the acceleration to gravity, right? So right here, what is w is equal to weight. And what is m? M is the mass. And what is mass of the body? And what is g? It is acceleration due to gravity. And detail we can study in the gravity chapter, gravitational chapter. So here only introduction is there. So acceleration due to gravity, and the value of g is, okay, the standard value of g is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, you need to remember this one, right? So students, these are all about the force here, right? The force is the cause for the acceleration of the body, and the force can change the speed, force can change the direction, and the force can change the shape, and then different types of forces, balance force and the unbalanced force. Okay, if the set of forces applied on the object not produce acceleration, it is the balance force is there. If produce acceleration, then it is unbalanced
force is there. So we can study the types of force, and then we study about common forces. There are common forces are there. One is contact force, and the contact force with normal force. Okay, next frictional force, and the string force exerted by the string, force exerted by the spring, and then weight. So these are what called as some common forces are there, students. Some is the non-contact force is also there. That is gravitational force is the non-contact force, and magnetic force is there, that not contact force. That is we already study in the next standards. Okay, here standards, but here only we take a contact force here, right? So not last one, that is SI unit of force is there. That is last point, that is simple point, that is SI unit of force. Okay, so here how do you calculate the SI force? Okay, so SI unit of force, SI unit of force. So the SI unit of force is, students, the SI unit of force is in Newton. What is a Newton? That is capital L. So remember this one, the because of the Newton induced about the force, so we kept an Newton name as a unit, so that is called Newton. So that is written, sorry, that is written as not like that, written like that, Newton in the small letters, and the symbol is a capital letter. Okay, so that is a Newton. So that is called a Newton. So what is mean, how much Newton may be? Okay, that is be in the next class, higher classes, we study that one, how much Newton weight must be. So we must remember that the force SI unit is a Newton. In the examination may be asked that what is the SI unit of force. So the SI unit of force is what? Newton. And the other unit also there, we can study in the next classes, right? First next classes. But here we only study about the Newton. The SI unit of force is called a Newton. So written as a cap, all symbols are smaller. And here again, symbol, all letters are small, and the this symbol is in the capital form. So okay, symbol is capital N. So student, this is about the unit of force here. Okay, so this is enough for today's class. In the next class, we take the very important concept, is first Galileo experiment and the first law of motion by the Newton law. Okay, that is Galileo's law of inertia or Newton first law, both are same. Can we study in the next video, in the next class. So this class is enough here, and this class is over, and this video is over, only about the force. So hope you understand these all the concept of force here. So meet in the next class with a new concept of force and laws of motion chapter. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. Okay, bye, meet in the next class. We'll be right back.